Hello, very good morning all. Today's class we are going to discussing about the WHO guidelines for assessment of herbal drugs. Herbal medicines are used around the world. As you know, WHO has developed a series of technical guidelines and documents relating to the safety and quality assurance of medicinal plants and herbal materials, which involves the quality control methods for medicinal plant materials, good agriculture and collection practices for medicinal plants, international pharmacopoeia, good manufacturing practices for the pharmaceutical products, supplementary guidelines for the manufacturing of herbal medicinal products, guide to storage practices of pharmaceuticals, good trade and distribution practices for the pharmaceutical starting materials, and the guidelines for research and evaluation of traditional medicine, and guidelines for assessment of herbal medicine. This is the part we are going to discussing about, and additional guidelines regarding the contaminants and residues, and WHO monographs on selected medicinal plants. So before going into the presentation, we need to know the term, what do you mean by herbal medicine? According to WHO, the herbal medicine includes the finished herbal products, the starting materials, that means raw materials for the production, such as medicinal plants, herbal materials, herbal preparations and herbal dosage forms. And as per WHO, every herbal medicine must be standardized. So let's discuss the objectives of the guidelines. The objective of WHO guideline is to define basic criteria for the evaluation of quality, safety and efficacy of the herbal drugs, thereby to assist national regulatory authorities, scientific organizations and manufacturers to undertake as assessment of the documentation submission with respect of such products. So the WHO guidelines involve the following categories: assessment of quality, assessment of safety, assessment of efficacy. First one, assessment of quality. First title, the pharmaceutical assessment. This part should cover all the important aspects of quality assessment of the herbal drugs according to the monographs in the official pharmacopoeia. And all the procedures should be in accordance with the good manufacturing practices, that means the GMP guidelines. Second one, crude plant material. The botanical definition, including genus, species and authority, should be specified. And the active constituents and the content limit should be specified. And foreign matter, impurities, microbial content should be defined or limited. Third one, the plant preparations. What do you mean by plant preparation? It includes the comminuted powdered plant materials, extracts, tinctures, essential oils, expressed juices and preparations. Whose production involves fractionation, purification or concentration in process. And the manufacturing procedure, active constituents, assay methods, chromatographic fingerprint should be added. Fourth one, finished product. The finished product specification should be defined. It involves the manufacturing procedure, formula, which include the details regarding the excipient should be described in detail. And for important finished products, the confirmation of the regulatory status in the country of origin should be required. And the WHO certification scheme on the quality of pharmaceutical should be applied. Fifth one, stability. The physical and chemical stability of the product in the container in which it is to be marketed should be tested under defined storage condition, and the shelf life should be established. Assessment of safety. Regulatory safety assessment of herbal medicinal products are very important, like adverse reactions and toxicity information. Next one, assessment of safety. So the safety assessment is very important, and it should cover all the relevant aspects of the safety of medicinal product. And if the product has been traditionally used without demonstrated harm, no specific restrictive regulatory action should be undertaken. But the new evidence demands a revised risk-benefit assessment. And the report of side effects should be documented according to the normal pharmacovigilance practices. And in the safety concern, next one, it is a toxicological studies. Toxicological studies, if available, should be part of the assessment, and the literature should be indicated. Next one, the documentation of the safety based on experience. Here, the period of use, the health disorders treated, the number of users, and the countries with experience should be specified. And if a toxicological risk is known, the toxicity data must be submitted. And the assessment of the risk, whether independent of dose or related to dose, should be documented. That means all the dosage specification must be documented. It's an important part of the risk assessment. Next one, assessment or evaluation of the efficacy. Efficacy studies of the herbal medicinal product should be carried out. So third one, assessment of efficacy. This should cover all the important aspects of efficacy assessment. A review of the relevant literature should be carried out, and the copies provided of the original articles or proper references made to them, and the research studies, if they exist, they should be taken into account. And the efficacy assessment should involve the following topics. First one, the activity, the pharmacological and clinical effects of the active ingredient, and if known, their constituents with therapeutic activity should be specified or described. And second one, the evidence required supporting indication. Here the indication for the use of the medicine should be specified. And in case of traditional medicine, say for example Ayurvedic medicine, the requirements for proof of efficacy should be depend on the kind of indication. That means the proof depends upon the indication. Endana adinde use adine depend edirikkum. In the assessment of efficacy, third one, the combination products. We know that many of the herbal remedies, they are polyherbal formulation. So the assessment should be made for the traditional and the new combination products separately. In case of the traditional products, say for example Ayurveda, traditional Chinese remedies, Yunani remedies, Siddha medicine, here the documentation are based on the experience that may serve as a evidence of efficacy. And where the traditional use has not been established, appropriate clinical evidence should be required. The herbal formulation also required to provide the product information for the consumer, which involved the name of the product, quantitative list of the active ingredients, dosage form, mode of administration, contraindication, warnings, precautions, use during the pregnancy and lactation, expiry date, lot number. And identification of the active ingredient by the Latin or botanical name in addition to the common name, it's required. And the promotion, here the advertisement and other promotional material directed to the health personnel and the general public should be fully consistent with the approved package information. We already discussed in the first slide that WHO has formulated a series of guidelines for the herbal medicines. It also include the additional guidelines for with reference to contaminants and residues, which involves the acceptable daily intake of a chemical, acceptable residue level, ARL norim. It's given in milligram of pesticide per kilogram of medicinal plant material that can be calculated from the maximum acceptable daily intake of the pesticide for humans, as recommended by the FAO and WHO. And permitted daily exposure, another parameter. It's also defined in the as per the ICH guidelines as a pharmaceutically acceptable intake of residual solvents to avoid confusion of differing ADIs. That means acceptable daily intake of for the same substance. Pesticide. According to WHO, the pesticides are the defined as any substance intended for preventing, destroying, attracting, repelling, or controlling any pest, including unwanted species of plants or animals, during the production, storage, transport, distribution, and processing. Next one, pesticide residue. Pesticide residues are any specified substance in food, agricultural commodities, or animal feed resulting from the use of pesticide. The term includes any derivatives of the pesticide, such as conversion products, metabolites, reaction products, and impurities considered to be the toxicological significance. Assessment of safety. Regulatory safety assessment of herbal medicinal products are very important, like adverse reactions and toxicity information.